So now it's time to go into all of these menu bar top panel here. So what we're going to do is actually go to File, New, and this is where you can create your new projects. You can, of course, open them and browse in a program known as Bridge, which is a great file organization and a renaming program. We'll go into that a little bit later since it's a separate program, but it's really useful in Photoshop, I found. There's also Mini Bridge, which is sort of a miniaturized version of it. You can open as a smart object. Or you can open up your recents. You can share your screen through the online sources and all that, create new reviews and all that. So this is sort of like online stuff that they toss in. You can close all and all that. And most of these things are not available because we don't have a project open. So let's actually open a project here. We won't even name it or save it right now, but you can see all the stuff that you're able to do. And now you can save as, and once you save as, you can save yet again. You can close and go to Bridge, close all your tabs and whatnot, which will be different projects. So you can close the current one, places and all that stuff like that. You can import and export. You can automate things like create a batch item or whatnot. You got lens correction. You can merge to HDR Pro. You can do photo merging and all that. Scripting, you're able to sort of automate things like go to your image processing or processor and rename or change the file save type from like a JPEG to a TIFF or a PNG or vice versa. You got different things like file info. If you bring that up, it'll tell you everything about your file that you have open and whatnot. And you can of course edit all this and the XMP data here, or the metadata. It is powered by XMP, so you're able to do a lot of stuff with this. So if you want to import your camera data, you can view all that. If you wanted to input like titles and artists and all that for copyright purposes, you can certainly do that. And there's a lot of stuff you can change here, of course. This scrolls over. So a lot of things that you can change here. You got preferences and all too. So we'll click OK there. And we'll move on from there. Of course, you can print and exit the program. Editing allows you to do basic edits such as your step forward and step backward or your undo. You can do fades of a current effect that you have applied. So if I wanted to do a quick gradient here, which for whatever reason I can't click and drag while my screen capture software is running, so that's odd. So let's do a workaround. Let's do a 64 by 64 and we'll fill it in with black. I'm gonna deselect. You guys don't have to follow along, but just for purposes. So I've placed that and we have the ability to apply a filter to that. So we can do let's do a Gaussian blur on that. Make it quite heavy. So it sort of looks like a dot. If we go under here and we choose the where the fade was, we could fade our Gaussian blur. And that only applies to the effect that you currently have just applied. You could, of course, change the blending mode of that as well. So you have sort of this outer glow type deal to it. It's pretty cool. Under here, we also have your cut, copy, paste. You can paste merged. You can check spelling. You can find replacement text. You can fill. You can do strokes. You can do content-aware scaling. You got your Puppet Warp tool, which is great in this version of Photoshop. There's so much you can do with it. If you transform, that's going to be really, really helpful. You got different transform options, such as rotating your image and whatnot. Purging, define brush presets, so you can make different brushes or define a custom brush that you've made in Photoshop. Let's see, anything really else here. Preferences are good to go under. I generally start under General here. And of course, you can choose different things, your interface, your file handling, your performance. Performance, you want to set up a secondary drive for your scratch drive. Generally, it should be a secondary separate hard drive on your computer. And that speeds things up a little bit. Cursors, you can change how those look. Under guides and rulers, I generally tend to choose what I want my guide color to be. Generally, it's cyan by default. And it's hard to see in a white background. So I change that to a light red. And of course, if you wanted to, you can go to our custom color. It'll bring up this menu right here, and you can choose whatever color you really want. You got different plugins you can add to this, and different settings you can go through there. Under image, you have the ability to go into mode. You can change this to 16 or 32-bit. You can change to grayscale and whatnot. Adjustments, you can adjust your brightness, contrast, and all your pretty much standard things. This version of Photoshop also has HDR toning, so you can do HDR photos. It's sort of a fake type setup, but hey, it's pretty cool, and it does a nice job in some cases. You got your auto adjustments for your tone, contrast, and color, your image size, your canvas size, your image rotation. Once again, you can rotate your images. Calculations, you can duplicate things. Layer allows you to add new layers, and we'll explain a little bit more on layers in a future video, but it's basically like an overhead projector where you're adding clear sheets of plastic and you're drawing on each sheet, and you can reorder them or paint on any sheet in between or below, and it's pretty cool to keep things organized and whatnot. You can even put those in folders. So you can do new layers, new layer from background, you can do a new group, which is sort of like a folder. You can delete these things, new layer styles and whatnot, which is sort of like artistic things you can put on. Selecting things, you have the ability to select a color range. You can refine your selections and refine your masks and all that, and you can do a quick mask mode. You can transform your selections. Under filter, you have the ability to, of course, do what we did before, apply like Gaussian blurs. You can turn this into a Chrome sketch. Some of these things will bring up a whole new dialog box once you click them. And in this case, it did, so it's going to take a little bit of a while for that to pop up. But generally, this will allow you to be like, okay, what's this going to look like in the end? And so you can do pretty cool things like this. And we can, of course, layer these more on that later. We'll apply that for now. Under view, you have the ability to proof your setup for different working conditions and whatnot. You got your comment warnings that you can change. You can customize or change your pixel aspect ratio. You can zoom in and out, which of course is Control plus the plus key or Control and the minus key. If you want to fit the screen, Control 0 or actual size or pixels, Control 1. Generally, I like to hold down my Alt key and scroll up and down, which in this case is not working either, probably because my screen capture software, once again, which I have to find out why it's doing that, but either way, trust me, it does work. You have the ability to turn on and off and show extras and whatnot, like your rulers and whatnot, stuff like that, and you could turn on and off snapping here too. Under window, you have the ability to open up many, many different windows. In fact, we're only seeing about probably 25% of the windows open here on these panels on the right and left side and on the top. But there's so many different things you can open up, like tool presets, swatches, styles, and I generally tend to open up a few more and close a few more, and then I save my workspace. You can, of course, go into workspace. I have my preset up here, and we'll show you how to do that by simply closing something down here. Let's say I want to close down this and sort of make it minimal. So it's sort of a shrunken version. If I click it, it pops out. And I don't want the layers at the bottom. Well, maybe I want them in the middle here, and I want my adjustment mask at the bottom. Well, I can then go under Window, Workspace, and of course I can reset the current workspace, delete current workspace, or I can create a new workspace, which is going to be called Dave 2. So now if we go back to our Essentials, go to Workspace, reset Essentials to what it was. If we go back to Dave 2, there's our preset. So generally, it's probably a better idea to make your preset, make it Dave 2, customize it, save, and then that way you don't have to go back and reset your essentials that you customized first. But either way, if I go under Dave 1 here, this is how I generally try to set up my workspace. So it's pretty cool what you can really do with the program. I'm going to go back to our essentials, which is how it's laid up by default. And of course, you can open up all these different things here. Under Help, you've got a bunch of different things you can go under. You got the help menu under the F1 key. It's a great thing to go under if you get stuck, or to search YouTube if you really want to. I got some older tutorials, but I show you how to do a lot still. We got different plug-in abouts, like we got Topaz Adjust and watermarks and all that, and Camera Raw. This will open up and read raw files if you have the updates for it, guys, so look into that. You got system information, product activation, all updates, and you got Photoshop Online if you sign up for that and all that. So it's pretty cool what you can do in Photoshop, and that is pretty much wrapped up this top bar. Next, we're going to go under Bridge and all these sort of different things for layouts. And in future videos, we'll start working our way down and towards the sides and show you what each tool does. I'm Dave from Sonic Orb Studios. Check out my website, sonicorbstudios.com. And until next time, I'm out of here. See you then.